Okay, and last but not least, which really sucks because I don't know, I've done the three videos. This is the fourth and final summer event vehicle that they've shown off in the dev blogs. And I've already done the previous three, and I'm already sick and tired of talking about this fucking game with another one of their events, which is, again, why I did not do a video on the event itself. But it sucks that I have to die out here on this particular dev blog, because it's actually of a pretty cool ship, and this is the HMS Renown, a new battlecruiser for, well, the British naval forces, obviously. And just because, I don't know, do they show, okay, they kind of show it here. They do show the collectible camouflage. Again, you can see that if you come over to the actual event page. They'll show each of them over there. I guess the only dev blog that didn't get to show it off was, I guess both of the ground vehicles, they didn't show it off on the actual dev blog for one reason or another. Anyways, this is the British battlecruiser, which wields 381mm guns, has perfect mobility, and a lethal anti-air arsenal. So meet one of the best damage dealers in the British lineup, locked behind a fucking event. It looks like Gaijin have changed some things based on recent events and community outlash, but they have not done anything to make their events any better or more logical. The HMS Renown, Battlecruiser Britain, for the 5th rank, which is of course not a premium, why the fuck would it be? You get 381mm main guns, high speed, low drag, multiple anti-air weapons. I like how we go from lethal AA arsenal to multiple AA guns, which could literally mean like three guns. Okay, here's some history on the unit though, if you're interested in learning more. I would normally read this stuff about these things, but like I said, I'm fucking sick of talking about this game right now. So here is some screenshots of the main batteries and a nice shot of the back. It's a very beautiful ship. We ignore how to obtain this thing. I would definitely have nothing but praises to give. In War Thunder, the HMS Renown is presented in the most complete upgrade made in 1944. Oh, so it's even the best version of the ship to boot. So if they ever add another HMS Renown to the game, it'll automatically be inferior to the event version. How typical is that? Which means that the outdated auxiliary 102mm guns are replaced by 10 twin universal mounts with 114mm guns. The gun mounts are placed in 5 on each side of the cruiser and come in handy both against light ships and enemy aircraft. In general, HMS Renown is one of the most difficult targets in the game for enemy aerial attacks. 114mm cannons start firing at long distances. The famous British 40mm pom-pom. Oh god, enough with these fucking nicknames, please. Gun mounts join when the target comes closer, followed by single twin-barreled 20mm weapons. So, of course, you know, planes being deleted, that is probably the best thing that I can say about this dev blog right now. The powerful arsenal, more than 1,400 crew members, as well as torpedoes and stationary torpedo tubes. Speeds of more than 30 knots, which is roughly 55 kilometers an hour. Sounds excellent, doesn't it? Well, now just play for fuckloads of hours to get this thing. And make sure you do it by Gaijin's two-day bullshit fucking time limit or whatever. And here's the, again, another shot that actually better shows off the paint scheme than the other one. I don't know, just the colors are not desaturated in this. The ship is modeled for War Thunder and her latest upgrade, with a 220mm armored belt, as well as 102mm armored deck. The most vulnerable areas of the ship are its main turrets with barbettes, capable of surviving no more than cruiser fire. Fantastic. Well, there you go. That's, again, it sucks that a beautiful ship like this has to be talked about with such little interest, which has nothing to do with the ship itself. It has to do with how to obtain the ship. But, well, presumably, since we're coming up to September, we'll actually get some non-event-related news content. I guess we'll just have to wait, but